Now we'll stay with politics and move to our state house. It's not every day a racehorse goes to the state capitol, but it happened yesterday. It was all part of the spectacle surrounding what rules Minnesota's racetracks will live under and how they'll survive the inevitable advent of sports betting in our state. The racetracks are especially upset about a bill that would make them remove their electronic elements in their card rooms and bar them from adding machines that would help them compete with the whole world of sports betting, should it cross the legislative finish line this time. John Croman has been tracking this one for years. Here's his report.
His name is Numbered Account, a harness racer from Running Aces, here at the state capitol taking part in a different kind of contest, a race against a bill that tracks say will threaten their industry.
It's devastating, and there are so many more people than just us, the employees. You've got communities. You've got people that love to come to the tracks. It's, as Aaron was saying, we're family friendly.
Running Aces CFO Tracy Wilson reacting to legislation that would drastically change the card table operations at Running Aces in Canterbury Park. The bill would limit tracks to traditional card tables with players standing physically next to the dealers. It would outlaw the video assist version of this, where players sit at terminals with a live feed from the dealer.
What it's really allowed people to do is to play games without worrying what somebody else is going to do or how they're going to talk on the table. And yet it still has, it plays like blackjack. It is a blackjack game.
In their player station, and they themselves can make a decision. Do I want to take a card? Do I want to hit? Do I want to stay? What do I want to do?
The bill's author, Democrat Zach Stevenson, says the video assist version of these card games violates the limit in state law of 80 card tables per racetrack.
Stadium-style card games have no such limitation. Not only that, but players can play multiple hands at once. So this technology renders the limit table limitation in Minnesota statute meaningless.
Stevenson's bill would also reverse last week's decision by the Minnesota Racing Commission to allow Running Aces in Canterbury to install new games called Historic Horse Racing, or HHRs, which allow you to place bets on past races.
I think these slot machines are not lawful at the tracks. I think the Racing Commission took an unlawful action last week when they approved them, and this bill corrects it.
The tracks assert those machines are not the same as slots, and they're necessary for them to survive the impact of legalized online sports betting.
The same people who bet on horses and play cards in our card rooms are the same people who will be betting online on the new sports betting apps. If we're not a part of that, we feel we should have something in the law that makes up for the losses that the state is giving to the tribes.
Stevenson's also carrying that sports betting bill, which gives tribal casinos exclusive rights to both in-person and mobile betting. It sets aside $625,000 of revenue for racetracks, which they say isn't enough.
So that's not obviously going to work, and the racing industry is going to be destroyed. We will no longer have racing.
Some folks have accused me of having it out for the tracks. That's not true. I've got no problem with the tracks. I do have a problem with the Racing Commission going beyond its statutory authority.
Now, Stevenson's bill passed today, the Commerce Committee, on a 9-8 vote. The only Democrat to vote against it, Brad Tabke, has both Mystic Lake and Canterbury in his district. And Jana, as you can imagine, this debate over racetrack machinery is going to continue for quite a while. And as part of the larger debate over, you know, why tribes have this exclusive right to slots and will also have the exclusive rights to sports betting, the way the bill's currently written.
Yeah, there's so many, pardon the pun, like tracks to follow in this when it comes to sports betting. It's a big tent and a lot of people have a vested interest. Is there any chance that everybody comes together on one big agreement, or you're not seeing it?
You know, hope springs eternal here. I think, you know, the tracks have said, if you let us keep these machines, we don't need sports betting. The tracks have said, if you give us $6 million a year out of the sports betting revenue, you know, stream, we'll be fine with not hosting betting. But there's other people who still want the tracks to host betting. So we'll see how it all turns out.
All right. Thank you so much, John Croman.
That sounds like something mom and dad would say.
That's how we talk at the Capitol. Thanks, Croman.